And welcome back to News Channel 3 Live at 9. He has had more than 30 top 40 hits on the Billboard country music charts.
Now singer Ronnie McDowell is conquering the art world with his new TV show. Ronnie joins us now with more on his new show, Painting America. Good to have you.
Hey, it's good to have it's good to have Memphis
in your corner.
I'm telling you, because my friend George Klein
yes.
is here.
Awesome, yeah.
And I love the cupboard. That's my favorite restaurant in the whole world.
You are really breaking it down for us, Ronnie, as you always
do. You got to go get the vegetable plate, of course.
Oh, Lord, the best turnip greens on the planet, anyway.
So that's what's keeping you healthy out there these days.
So we made it sound like art was a new thing for you, but you actually have always been a visual artist. We just maybe didn't know about it. The public didn't.
I'm not to interrupt, but I'm actually a Disney artist as well. I've been painting for Disney for 5 years.
Wow.
And I started in 1956 when I was six. In the first grade, I painted a great big old red fire engine for my teacher, and I've been doing it ever since. Now, when I was a kid, every Sunday night, this would come into our living room.
Okay.
Y'all remember this? The world is a carousel of color.
Yep.
Remember that?
The wonderful world. Yeah.
How could I have ever dreamed that I'd be painting for Walt Disney? So have I been blessed, Alan?
I would say so, Ronnie. I would say you have, for sure.
So
where's your passion, though? Do you think it's more in the art world when it comes to some of the illustrations we're about to show, or is it the music, or is it a combination of them all?
Well, you know, the right side of the brain is the arts and the entertainment.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
And it's just a combination of all of it, because my first passion, I would probably have to say, is songwriting.
Okay.
And I wrote the theme to the new Painting America, and it sounds like a 1987 throwback song.
Okay.
So I've been writing songs. The first song I ever wrote was for Johnny Cash. I just got out of Vietnam. I'm a three-term combat veteran of the Vietnam War.
Huh.
And I just got out of Vietnam. I walked into the house of Cash, and I said, I have written you a song. And I sang Johnny Cash a song. See,
wait a minute,
and
Ronnie.
He liked,
walked in like that?
Oh, I just walked in and I said, I've sang you a song. And I went, well, I believe in good old rock and roll. And I believe that music is the soul of country, blues, and pop. I could never knock hard rock, 'cause all in all, it's rhythm from the heart.
And what did Johnny say?
Well, I'm going to have to tell you. He said, son, you've been studying me.
Been studying quite well, I might say.
So tell us about this TV show, because you're going to be wrapping up the filming tomorrow night.
Tomorrow night in Tupelo.
In Tupelo.
And this picture I'm holding up right here also.
Yeah, this is kind of like a prelude to the new painting. Well, the new painting is a prelude to this one. This is Elvis at 10 years old in the little house he was born in, looking in the mirror and seeing his 1956 self looking back at his 10-year-old self like, are you really sure we want to get into this?
I love that.
Ronnie, you know, it takes a lot of creativity. I don't know where you find it in that brain of yours to see something like that. Where does that come from?
You know, Alan, I'm going to be totally honest with you. It's like a song. It comes to me the same exact way a song does. I literally saw this.
Mm-hmm.
I woke up one morning and I went, wow, it came to me. But you know what that is? It's that Holy Spirit. It's that little voice on your shoulder when you write a song. Mm-hmm. Because it just comes to me out of nowhere. That's a divine thing. So this new painting, a friend of mine came up to me and he goes, how come nobody's ever painted the moment that Elvis got his first guitar at the Tupelo Hardware Store?
Which is a true story, right? Mm-hmm.
Yes, for $7.75.
Wow.
He wanted something else, right, in his mother bought
him. He wanted a .22 rifle.
Well,
now think about this. What if he had got the rifle?
That's
thank
a lot
God
to think
he,
about there.
Thank God he didn't. We wouldn't have music the way we have it.
I know.
So back to the show, you're taking these moments of Americana,
mm-hmm.
and basically it's a TV show. Where's it going to air?
It's going to be HGTV.
Okay.
And hopefully. And
part of it will include a concert, right, at the site?
Not all of them.
Not
but
all?
This first one will be the pilot, and the reason why is because that idea that Bernard gave me, a friend of mine, is such a wonderful moment in history. It changed culture.
Right, when Elvis got the guitar.
Yes, and so we did the whole theme around that. We were going to reproduce when I gave Dolly Parton hers.
Okay. I've got that.
But the producer said, nobody's bigger than Elvis. No offense against Dolly. She and I did a duet not long ago, and she said, I always wanted Elvis this to do I Will Always Love You. And so when I left there, of course, he never got a chance to, I thought, well, I'm going to paint Dolly singing it to Elvis on a picnic.
Whoa.
And when I gave her this painting, Alan, she jumped back and she goes, wow, I wish I looked like that.
Wow.
You do make her look very good.
Well, they both look great.
I Will Always Love You. Wow.
That is. This will be a subject
of the
show.
And that's one of her classic songs that was, of course, redone by Whitney Houston.
Yeah.
Right. Awesome. Okay, so when can we expect the show to begin?
The show will probably, we hope, air. I just did Ray Stevens' show when we debuted it on there because it will not air till May.
Okay.
But we're hoping that ours will come around about April.
And you can be a part of it by going tomorrow night to the taping, the final taping.
Well, actually, that show is sold out.
Oh, it is?
Yeah, for some reason,
the horse
is unseen. We couldn't do a second show, but the show is sold out. But we wanted to get that big wow factor.
Yeah, we'll be able to watch.
I can't wait till you see this.
We'll be checking it out. Glad to have you back here.
You remind me of Norman Rockwell.
Yeah.
Disney is
great
lucky.
Great picture, see it for sure.
By the way, I got to tell y'all, when I was a little boy, it wasn't just Johnny Cash. I heard this voice, Alan, at 7, and I thought, I've got to try to do that. Can you imagine me at 7 going, I said, hello, Dolly. This is Dolly. So everybody influenced me. So it's not just the art, it's voices.
Yeah. You got a million voices in there, and they all sound good.
Ronnie McDowell.
Glad to have you back here.